It's official. The next pack for The Sims 4 is Island Living, and that surprises literally no one. There have been at least 3 retail leaks that I know of. If you're not sure, if you haven't heard, it's all over Twitter. It has been all over Twitter for like months because retail really does leak a lot of this stuff. But someone, you know who you are, and I want to say thank you to the Sims community webpage for having all of this information out there so that we as a community can oogle and ogle and ooh and ah. But someone went in to the Origin website and started typing in things in the URL address just to see what was gonna happen. And they found out that the pack is called Island Living. I almost called it City Living. No. Island Living, honey. And they also got us a whole set of images, and I'm like, we have to talk about this. So a little bit backstory on me. I play The Sims 3 and The Sims 4. The Sims 3 Island Paradise is not good. It's full of lag. I've like dedicated part of a video about mod-free fixes for lag, just talking about Isla Paradiso. So that wasn't a great thing for me, but you know, I do enjoy a lot of the things from it. I am a tropical girl. In The Sims 4, I have done Isle of the Midnight Sun, and I would love to get back into that and give their house a makeover. You basically, the whole story of Isle of the Midnight Sun is you crash land on a tropical island and you have to survive. So this pack is like right up my alley because their house looks very untropical. Very, very untropical. And I'd love to give it a tropical makeover and get back into it. I would love some of the things that I really enjoy from my 100 baby 100 puppy, which is mermaids basically, to come back over to The Sims 4. I would love it. So let's talk about the first image. And I will say I am excited but also cautious because you know EA. EA can sometimes make decisions that you don't agree with, like non-playable pets and other things I can talk about, but I don't want to talk about here. So let's focus on the picture, shall we? Oh my goodness, there's so much to talk about. So let's talk about the jet ski, first and foremost. I never really was able to do the whole jet ski fun. Basically, it's Isla Paradiso in The Sims 3 or nothing. Maybe Sunlit Tides if you're lucky. But I never got to do that because it was such a lag fest. So I'm excited to maybe possibly have a jet ski and drive around on it. I don't know. I'm hopeful that they don't just put the jet ski beside the dock and use it like the boats in Burnleton Bay, where you just click on them and you go someplace. I'm like, no, don't you dare do that. I need to be on it and going around and meeting people and being able to go from beach to beach to beach. You know, no, don't you dare. Don't you dare make that just like the elevators that just teleport you somewhere. I'm sure that wouldn't go over very well. Just saying. We also have a lifeguard, which I'm not sure if that's going to be a career or not. I would say no, that they're just gonna wander the beaches like an NPC. I hope not, but I love the lounger. Like, please bring that back. I use that thing so much in The Sims 3, you know, just to have people get out of my hair. I play big households. We're talking 25 to 30 people in The Sims 3. Yes, I'm crazy. If you watch my 100 baby 100 puppy, yeah, I'm crazy. But I would like to have those back so I can just, you know, put people on them and get them out of my way. Because sometimes, you know, those Sims that just get in your way and are just like, can I put you in a hole in the ground? Yes, I have done that. In The Sims 3, I have dug a hole in the ground and put people in it because I'm tired of dealing with them. And we're not talking about like a grave. We're talking about just digging a hole, like a foundation, a basement, just putting them in there and just being like, stay there for a while. Yes, I am crazy and I love it. I love it so much. But the loungers were like a fun thing. You know, you gotta read a book, but it's a beautiful day. Go outside on the lounger, read your book, take a nap, have fun, get out of my hair. I'm also really digging this, like the snorkeling. It's not really snorkeling. It's another thing. It's called, it is snorkeling. It's scuba diving, that's the other one. I'm hopeful for just, you know, something to do underwater. You know, if we just get snorkeling and you can go over a reef. I'm really hoping the snorkeling is in a rabbit hole. I'm hoping that EA has learned their lesson from Outdoor Retreat. And it's great that outdoor retreat had hikes. But that was a rabbit hole. And I don't think anybody has ever said, oh, I just love the hikes. No, it was not fun. And I'm hopeful that we'll be able to do something in the water. You know, swimming, underwater, snorkeling, would love that. I'm sure swimming is a shoo-in, but snorkeling would be cool. Scuba diving would be amazing, but I'm not holding my breath. Puns. I didn't intend for that to be a pun, but it was. So let's talk about, like, the mermaids, please, because I would love to play as a mermaid, and it has a little plumbob over its head, so I'm like, please, please, can we play as mermaids, please? I played as a mermaid, and I will never do it again, in the situation of a hunter baby, hunter puppy, where I had a bunch of mermaid babies, and it was just nightmare. It was a nightmare. Whoa, it was bad. It was really bad in season 2 with the mermaids and teenagers who were all mermaids, who all have to get in the water, who all need kelp to eat. I'm like, can we have some, like, if we're gonna play as mermaids, can we have some kelp dishes to make? Because I feel like whenever I have a married couple, I'm doing like a hybrid challenge in Hunter Baby, Hunter Puppy, and I feel like the guy cries because he's the chef. He's level 10, and most of his household just eats kelp. I feel like he just sobs every day. I have this skill, but I can't cook for anybody. Can we have like a kelp salad or a kelp juice or something? More than just sticking a wad of kelp in your mouth. That would be nice. Maybe get rid of the kelp altogether. I don't know. But let's talk about bathing suits because, oh my god, I have said for so long, I need more bathing suits. I need more bathing suits. I need more bathing suits. And every pack comes out, and I don't own Seasons, but every pack comes out, no new bathing suits, no new bathing suits. They do the backyard set, no new bathing suits. And I'm just like, really? I need maybe some bathing suits. So I am excited to see that we have a plethora of bathing suits, you know, bikini tops, bikini bottoms, you know, scuba suits. Like, yes, finally, finally bathing suits. I'm so excited for that. I am very, very excited that they're bringing back bathing suits. Oh my gosh. So let's move on to the next image of the toddler on the beach. That is so cute. Oh my gosh. I love your little two-piece. It's adorable. And I love that there's a sandcastle sitting there. One of my favorite things in The Sims 3 to put down is the big sandbox because a bunch of kids can play with it, and I play in houses that have 25 to 30 Sims, so I need something to keep them, you know, out of the way. I know, I'm crazy. I will fully admit and revel in the fact that I am crazy, but I love that they can make sandcastles and bury toys and stuff in The Sims 3, so making sandcastles in The Sims 4 and you can just do it on the beach without having the box, would love, love, love to be able to do that. I love the lounger. That's really nice. We've been wanting those for a while. Thank goodness. We can finally have them when people aren't sticking two pieces of furniture together to make like a pseudo lounger. But something else that catches my eye is the boat. Now, I loved windsurfing in any town that was not Isla Paradiso and had oceans. So that was what? Sunlit tides? And I would like to get back to that. That's a lot of fun to just cruise around and just enjoy the day. So I am excited to see the boats and the jet ski. I'm hopeful that they are things that you can own and they're not just going to be, you know, in the background cruising around and you just feel left out. Fingers crossed. I'm also hopeful that this is not going to be a holiday resort where you can only stay a week, because I'm hopeful that they learned their lesson with the outdoor retreat and all the people who wanted to live in the forest wonderland and could not. I was one of those people. I mean, duh, forest is in my name. Well, woods, same thing, same difference. I love that. I would love to be able to live there. And I believe there's mods that allow you to live there. So if this turns out to be a holiday resort town, you can only live here for a vacation, I'm just like, give me some mods. I'll just break the game and live here. It's my game, I can break it. I'm a little bit unsure about all of the palm trees. Like, I would love if there was better scenery. I mean, is that a volcano back there? Great. I would love to see like a resort and more of the ocean and not just palm trees. Like, I get it. Palm trees are everywhere when you go somewhere tropical, but they also have views of the ocean. It's just palm tree palooza. So I'm like, maybe cut down some of the palm trees and give us a better look. Maybe. I don't know. Maybe there's something back that they're trying to hide. I have no clue, but yeah, I would like a better view if I'm going to be paying for a vacation or beachfront property. Just saying, it would be nice if there was actually something to look at besides a pointy rock and a bunch of trees and a little bit of blue. Yeah, well, I'm hopeful that this is just one side of the island that just happens to have a bunch of palm trees. So let's move on to the sunburn picture, because I was like, yes, finally sunburn! So many people were mad when Seasons came out and there was no sunburn. People were like, where's the sunburn? And I'm like, yeah, you might have wanted to add that to the pack, but I see what they were doing. They wanted to put it in with this island stuff, and I'm like, okay. Yeah, that's nice. I'm hoping that it's not gonna be like you burst into flames when you have too much sun. I'm like, no. Real people don't do that. I'm okay for, like, heat sickness or heat stroke, something like that, fine. You get a bad mood lit and you can't be out in the sun for like 24 hours or something because you were out too long, you indulged too much, great, perfect, but please don't make my sim burst into flames. I can't tell you how many times that's happened, and it's usually to the single sims who have no one to come and put them out, and they just end up dying, and you're like, well, okay, I guess we'll go back to an old save and try again. I'm really digging all of the build buy stuff. Like, yes, I can't wait. I can't wait to dive into my Isle of the Midnight Sun game and give her a better makeover. Like, her house is very cabin in a tropical setting. I'm like, no, this doesn't work. Doesn't work at all. I am excited to be able to, like, break down her house and give it a makeover and give her more tropical clothes, because the stuff she's got is, like, clothes and bathing suit, and I'm like, I'm seeing some cool stuff here. I'm liking it. I really want to add that to her file and make her a really awesome house, because she deserves it. She's one of my older families, and she's got a special place in my heart. She totally deserves more cool tropical stuff. I love the clothes. I'm not really sure about the skirt. Are those pants? Skirt over pants? I don't know. That seems a little bit hot for a tropical thing. You know, you want to wear a few clothes, not wear pants and a skirt. I don't know. I don't know how I feel about that. Maybe I'll want some CC person to separate those. Not really sure about the skirt over pants. I think that would be way too hot in a tropical setting, but, you know, whatever. I think the skirt over a bikini bottom would be much cuter. Just my opinion. I really like seeing all the different, like, tops that could be swimsuits if you wanted to. That was my way of getting around no swimsuits, really, that I wanted to use. But I would go through and find, like, tops that were sort of like tank top-ish or halter top-ish, and I would kind of try to match the colors with, like, bikini bottoms and make my own swimwear and stuff. It was great to do that, but I'm still probably gonna do that. But it's nice to have more stuff that you can add to that, things that would sort of be unique if they were bathing suits, but you can kind of get away with it, if you follow what I'm saying. I don't mind doing that, but I am super excited for more clothing that could possibly be stuff that you could wear to the beach and swimming. So the next image is got a dolphin in it, and I'm like, please don't let this be just a thing that swims in the ocean and you can't do anything with it. I'm hopeful that it might just swim around as, like, a nice little friend. Maybe it'll have some shark friends. I don't know. But I know people, like, really love Nessie. That's off in the distance. It looks like the Loch Ness Monster. Great. I don't want to see dolphins, like, way off in the distance just swimming around, and I can't interact with them. That's like a tease. That's like, hey, these are cute dolphins. Bah, you can't play with them. Like, I'm hopeful, because she's tossing fish, that we might have, like, swimming with the dolphins kind of thing. Fingers crossed. I hope. We'll have to find out at EA Play. I'm hopeful that they'll have more information because, yes, dolphins, please, thank you. Something else I've noticed are the shorts. And if we go back to the one that I showed you first with the green shorts here, don't we have shorts that look like identical to this? Don't we have shorts that look like that? I think we do. They're a little bit like that, and they have, like, I don't want to say camouflage, but they have, like, a pattern to them. Like, they're in green and pink and purple and blue. We have shorts that look like that, and I'm a little bit worried that they just took the mesh and made new clothes, like, recolored it and is like, here, have another item. The Sims team is really notorious for doing that. There's a lot of recycled content in this, in a lot of the packs, and I mean, I will take new shorts any day. But I really wish they had given us, you know, if this is the same mesh, just different colors. I really wish they would have given us something that was new and unique. I mean, I know there's only so many ways that you can make, you know, shorts, but I'm sure they could have, you know, come up with a new idea. I don't know. Those look spot on for the ones that we already have in the game. I don't know. We'll have to see. So the last picture is of this cool little like luau barbecue thing. And is this a pit in the ground used for roasting like a pig or something? If it is, cool. If it's just a really neat like fire pit, that's fine. But when I saw this, I was like, that sort of looks like it's smoking something. You know, like when they put a pig in the ground and they want to smoke it and cook it. That's sort of what it looks like. I'm not sure. I've never been to a luau. I've never been to Hawaii. But yeah, I would think that's what that is, but I'm not sure. You know, it could just be a nice, pretty fire pit. Who knows? But I'm really digging a lot of this island build-by stuff. These tikis are just... Is that flowers? I think that's a tiki torch with flowers on the side. Now, I'm a flower and plant lover in this game. I go out and I look for as many plants and other fun things as I can find because I absolutely want them in my game. And anytime you give me more plants, I will love you because there's never enough plants. But I'm really enjoying like the awning there over the seats. That's cute. Adorable. Adorable little fishies. Are those mobile? I'm not sure. They might just be a... No, they don't look like a mobile. It looks like a rod with a dangling fish. Like, not really a wind chime, but something very similar. I love the new lights, the new plants, the new decorations. Awesome. Can't wait. Can't wait to get my hands on it. And if rumors are to be believed, it might just be this month. I don't know. The rumors were dead on about this being island paradise, island living, you know, tropical paradise, dead on. So maybe their release date of the end of this month is true as well. Who knows? I guess we'll find out at EA Play. So thank you guys for listening to me ramble about these pictures and just squeal like a child because I have been wanting something tropical for quite some time and this looks amazing. Farewell, my dear friends. Don't forget to hit the like button to let me know you want to see more. Ready for another adventure? You can watch another episode of this series or you can try something brand new. There's more recommendations in the cards in the upper right hand corner as well. There is always more coming to the channel every single day, so come back for more adventures real soon.